Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is cloud storage, how does it work, a few benefits it offers, and a lot more. So let's get started. First, let's brush up the basics. Let's understand what does cloud, cloud computing, and cloud storage mean. Well, the cloud is an internet data center where software and services reside. Instead of them being stored on a local hardware, such as your computer or any other electronic device. Cloud computing is something which harnesses the power of the internet to outsource tasks such as housing software or file storage. And cloud storage refers to the process of saving data to an offsite storage system, or to state more technically, stashing data on a hardware in a remote physical location, which can be accessed from any device via the internet. In this case, clients send files to the data server maintained by a cloud provider instead of storing it on their own hard drives. A good example of such a service would be Dropbox, which lets users store and share files through ease of internet. These cloud storage systems generally encompass hundreds of data servers linked together by a master control server, but the simplest system might involve just one as well. And so to think, this also allows you to build backup and access your files from any device that is connected to the internet. So the next time you ask, where's my stuff? Once you get it onto the platforms like Dropbox, the answer would be two words: data centers. As anything you uploaded to the cloud or anything that you run from cloud exists on a dedicated server and storage volumes housed in vast warehouses, often situated on campuses full of such warehouses. And these data centers are owned by cloud service providers who are responsible for keeping the servers up and running. And to say the job of all these data centers, however big or small, is to keep your data physically safe from theft and destruction, and to make sure it's available whenever you want to access it. Next, let's understand how does cloud storage work. Well, to be honest, cloud storage works simple and easy. Here, once you purchase your cloud storage from a third-party cloud vendor, they own and operate their data storage capacity and deliver it to you over the internet in a pay-as-you-go model. These cloud storage vendors manage capacity, security, and durability to make data accessible to your applications all around the world. These applications can access cloud storage through traditional storage protocols or directly via an API. And to your surprise, many such vendors offer complementary services designed to help collect, manage, secure, and analyze data at a massive scale. Some of the best cloud vendors that I can recommend are Amazon Web Services or AWS, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud Platform, and DigitalOcean. But managing them all can be quite a task. So, in case you're looking for a managed cloud hosting provider, then I'll highly recommend you using Cloudways, as it's built for high performance with faster growth, which allows you to get more work done in less time. Next, let's talk about the advantages or benefits of cloud storage. The first one being accessibility, as our files are accessible from any device with an internet connection. Number two, scalability, as it is no longer necessary to purchase thousands of dollars of hardware, software, and server space for a just-in-case scenario. Number three, disaster recovery, as any cloud storage offers constant storage backup that are made to a secure offsite location. Number four, ease of use, as in many cases, one can simply drag and drop your files from one location onto your smartphone or computer into the cloud. Number five, using cloud storage eliminates the need for an on-site server maintenance. And last but not the least, number six, security, as the data on cloud is protected by a combination of strong encryptions, with help of which any unauthorized person cannot access the files shared or uploaded by you. Next, now that we understand what is cloud storage and how does it work, let's understand some of the main considerations we should account for when implementing a cloud storage solution. Number 1. Security. As all the data is ideally encrypted both at rest and in transit, permissions and access control should work just as well in cloud as they do for on-premise storage. Number 2. Durability. On cloud, data should be redundantly stored, ideally across multiple facilities and in multiple devices in each facility. And in such a case, natural disasters, human error, or mechanical faults should not result in a data loss. Number 3. Availability. By this, we mean to say that all data should be available when needed, as there's a difference between retrieving production data and archives. And henceforth, the ideal cloud storage should deliver the right balance of retrieval times and cost. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.